To factor this expression, let's start by rewriting both terms using the common factor or lowest exponent. So in this case, the lowest exponent is going to be negative 1/2. So I want to try to get a negative 1/2 here. So I'm going to keep 4x to the negative 1/2 the same. But I want to try and use this x to the 7/2 and get a negative 1/2 exponent out of that. So let's look at the 7. I need to come up with x to the negative 1/2, but I need to make sure that this still is equivalent to x to the 7/2. So if I were to include a x to the 8/2, then remember this that I have here in red, if I were to go here and actually simplify that, remember I have the same base, so I would add the exponents. And then what is negative 1 plus 8? That's 7. So I've just written x to the 7/2 as a product, but a product that includes x to the negative 1/2, because I wanted to include it because it's included in the first term as well. So now I'm going to look for the common factor, which in this case is x to the negative 1/2. Both terms have that common factor, so I can factor that out and then write what is remaining. So what's remaining in the first term is 4, because if I were to double check, x to the negative 1/2 times 4 would give me my 4x to the negative 1/2. Okay, let's continue. Then factor out x to the negative 1/2 in the second term, and I'll have plus 11 times x to the, and remember that 8 divided by 2 is just 4. To factor this expression, let's rewrite both terms, or one of the terms, so that both terms have the common factor, or the lowest exponent. So the lowest exponent is 1/3. So I want to change 7/3 to include 1/3. So I'm going to think about 1/3 plus what gives me 7/3. So if I were to add 6/3 to 1/3, that would give me 7/3. So I can change my second term to be x to the 1/3 times x to the 6/3. Because as I've shown here, that still would equal x to the 7/3. So let me rewrite the first one. So it's going to be x to the 1/3 minus x to the 1/3 times x to the 6/3. Now I can see that I can factor out x to the 1/3. So if I factor that out, I'm going to write it, and then in parentheses I'm going to write what's remaining. So if I factor out x to the 1/3 out of x to the 1/3, I'm left with just 1. And that's because if I were to distribute x times 1/3 times 1, that gives me my original x to the 1/3. And then I'm going to factor out x to the 1/3 out of the second term, and that's going to leave me minus x to the 6/3. And now I can simplify 6 divided by 3, that's just 2. So my answer is going to be x to the 1/3, which was the common factor I factored out, times 1 minus x squared. Now your book actually stops here, but you could continue because if you notice, 1 minus x squared is the same thing as a squared minus b squared, the difference of two squares. So you could actually continue and factor this binomial by saying 1 minus x times 1 plus x, because 1 is the same thing as 1 squared and then minus x squared. So you could continue and get this answer as well. To factor this, we need to find the lowest exponent. So we've got negative 3 over 5, 3 over 5, and negative 1 over 5. So the lowest exponent is going to be the negative 3 over 5. That's the lowest exponent. So we want to include that lowest exponent in all of the terms that don't have that as in lowest exponent. So let's focus on the second term because the first term is okay. So I'm going to rewrite the first term as it is. Then I'm going to work on the second term. So I want to include x to the negative 3 over 5. And then if I were to add 6 over 5 to negative 3 over 5, I would have positive 3 over 5. So I'm going to include that 6 over 5. And the reason why I'm doing that again, let me just show you here on the side. If I were to add negative 3 over 5 plus 6 over 5, that would give me 3 over 5 because negative 3 plus 6 is positive 3. So that's why I'm wanting to include 6 over 5 with my second term. Okay, so now let's focus on the last term. I want to keep the 1/10, and I want to incorporate that lowest exponent, which is x to the negative 3 over 5. Now, I want this to equal x to the negative 1 over 5. So negative 3 over 5 plus 2 over 5 would give me negative 1 over 5. So that's why I'm including 2 over 5 in my third term. So now I have those common terms, that lowest exponent, in each term here. So now I'm ready to factor it out. So once I factor that out, I'm going to write it. And then in parentheses, I'm going to write what's left over. So x to the negative 3 over 5 times 1 over 4 gives you 1/4 x to the negative 3 over 5. So I'm going to write that. Okay, so what times x to the negative 3 over 5 will give me my second term? That would be minus 9 x to the 6 over 5. And then what times x to the negative 3 over 5 will give me my third term? That would be plus 1 over 10 times x to the 2 over 5. So basically, you're trying to identify the lowest exponent, which in this case was this negative 3 over 5. And we wanted to rewrite every term so that it includes that lowest exponent. And that's what we did in the second terms here. And then we factor out that common factor that has that lowest exponent. And then we write what is remaining.